Hi, greetings and welcome fellow YouTubers out there. This week on the weekly updates, PlayStation has dropped a whole load of PSVR titles. We chilled out in a couple of airplanes in Ace Combat, had a look at a strange planet in Solus Project, and just chilled out a little bit in Star Citizen. So all that coming up on this week's weekly update. Greetings and welcome, fellow PlayStation VR enthusiasts. Yes, this week on this PlayStation YouTube channel, they have just flooded ourselves. They just bought a whole load of PlayStation VR games that are coming out. So it's really looking, the future's really looking quite good for PlayStation VR. They've got some, sorry if I'm looking down here, it's just because I've got my list down here. They have announced Doom, Song in the Smoke, After the Fall, Zenith, Fract, and I Expect You to Die 2. These are all games that have been announced for up and coming release with PlayStation VR. And I must admit, each one of them looks really quite awesome. Doom 3 is an old game that you used to play on the PC. Is that, yeah, I think it was a PC. Yeah, I think I did play on the PC, it wasn't console. But yeah, Doom 3 is a little bit of a further expansion. It kind of got sidetracked. Not many people liked Doom 3 because it was way too dark. And you had to like switch between like a shotgun or a flashlight to see where you're going. So there was some problems with Doom 3 and how it was set up and designed. But let's see how it works with the new VR, because the advert for it looks absolutely amazing, and it works with the aim control as well. So Doom 3 is definitely one that I'm going to be getting. As a fan of the Doom series, played every single episode of Doom ever since it came out from Doom 1. I have loved Doom, and I really am kind of looking forward to this when it comes out into the PlayStation VR, which will be at the end of this month. I think they said about the 23rd of March, or was it May? But yeah, that's coming soon. Next one, Song in the Smoke, which is a bit of a crafting experience. It also looks like a really decent exploration type of game. Now, as I saw it, I'm not too sure what that lion is doing there in the trailer, but I mean, it really looks quite awesome. Having to craft things like bows and arrows, campfires, building up stuff. And then using what you craft to go out exploring. Very Minecraft style, but in a big open world. So, and I'm kind of getting the idea or hint from the trailer that you might even be able to tame some of the animals. I don't know. I've only seen what's in this trailer here. I really do like the look of that lion. I would love to have that as a pet, if that's possible. Or it could be just a boss fight. But yeah. Song in the Smoke really does look like a good crafting and exploration type game. The After the Fall cinematic trailer doesn't actually show any sort of gameplay elements, but I'm getting a sort of motorbike banging away outside the window. Sorry about that, but yeah, I'm getting a sort of like zombie apocalypse style. But I'm trying to wonder how it's working in with the theme. So After the Fall, maybe something comes falling down from the sky and as sort of like a zombie invasion. Because in this scene, you see like hordes of these. They look like zombies, very fast running zombies chasing after them. Hordes of them, thousands of them. And then this giant smasher, as they call it, smashes down and tries to beat the living daylights out of them. But then they escape in the van. But yeah, that does actually look promising. Although cinematic trailers doesn't always represent gameplay elements, but we'll have to see how it goes. It does look kind of interesting going forward.
Over here, get in quick! Come on! Smash the red coming!
Sure hits differently these days, don't you think?
Zenith is a VR MMO. Now, I'm always for VR MMOs. Sorry. Right. Because each VR MMO that comes out brings us one step closer to the Oasis. But yeah. Zenith looks like it is sort of a multiplayer online game where you go around exploring like these worlds. You've got magic crafting, you've got sword fighting. I hope it goes a little bit better than Orbis, I think, because Orbis on the Quest, I really was quite looking forward to getting Orbis on the Quest. Unfortunately, some of the elements they made in were quite tricky and quite difficult. Now, I'm all for difficult levels of gameplay, but in Orbis, if you try to go for a spellcaster, you have to craft out runes in space to actually produce a spell. But they're so hard to actually craft, you kind of keep missing the actual patterns. And then in the end, I ended up going for that gunslinger road because it was easy just to point and shoot. This one here, Zenith, doesn't look like it's going for that. It might just do like a quick pull down to bring up a magic spell. Hopefully more aligned Waltz of the Wizards, or... I can't remember what was the name of the game. There was another VR game, a wizard-based game, where basically all that I needed to do to create a fireball was go like... press the control button, go like that with the joystick, and the fireball will appear in the hand. Nice, easy, intuitive to actually do, and then you can't cast it out. That was easy done, and I hope that when we see Zenith, magic spell casting works along the same way as that, rather than along the same way as what Orbis did, and where you have to like craft out complex runes in space, and if you get it wrong because your hand's shaky or anything like that, then you start over again and you have to pick another class because you're useless at doing it. But hey ho, we'll see how it goes. Fract is an action adventure game. It kind of reminds me of Blood and Truth that we played just a week back, where basically you were moving from point A to point B. And you've got like loads of people shooting at you from left, right and centre. The story mode was wonderful. I loved Blood and Truth. Although the control style of Blood and Truth was one of those that I didn't really like. I hated that control style. But the way that they used it in Blood and Truth was spot on. It was perfect and I loved it. And this is what Fract looked like. Instead of being like... city gangsters, it more or less looks like operation of covert forces, military soldier skiing in the snow while shooting AKs or whatever the guns might be. But yeah, Fract does look like a nice, good action adventure game with lots of shooting, lots of fighting, lots of explosions. And you know me, I like my explosions, and I think I'm going to like Fract when it comes out. And last of them was I Expect You to Die Number 2. Or as I like to write for it, I Expect You to Die 2. As in, I'm going to die, but I expect you to die as well. I like that little play on the words there. I Expect You to Die Too. Now, the original I Expect You to Die was a great puzzle game. Although more or less in a stylized version of graphics, the puzzle, it was a series of escape rooms, and you have to go from, you go into one escape room and you have to like try and figure out how to get to like the next part and the next. Well, you know how escape rooms work. And it was all done in the style of you're this spy and you need to try and achieve an objective. But at the same time, you've got bombs hidden around the room, you've got explosive gases or well, anything can happen. I think in the last one there was like a giant city destroying bomb that was fired from the moon and a laser from the opposite. Yeah, there was so much in I Expect You to Die 1 in the first video. And this one looks like it is not going to disappoint. It is going to impress exactly the same way the first one did. And again, I am looking forward to that. Okay, that's the trailers out of the way. I'll probably do a little bit of a montage here just to show a couple of them all playing at once so you can have a nice little look at that. I will do a little bit of a series later on the adverts, but moving on along, what did we do on Monday and Tuesday, Pistol Whip? Right, now I've been working on this little series for Pistol Whip Up, Pistol Whip Leveled Up. That basically, well, I am wearing one of the several of these. Now, this is an arm weight, or it is weighted clothes. This is about 2 kilograms of weight here, and I'm wearing four of them, so two on each arm. So I basically slide them on. I slide them onto my hands. Oh, yeah. I might not be able to get it while I've got my jacket on, but yeah. So basically, I'm sliding this. So that's 4 kilograms of weight on there, and I do the same on both arms. So 4 kilograms on the left, 4 kilograms on the right, making a total of 8. Kilograms. Oh wait, drop that over there. I'll leave that. but yeah, so that's 8 kilograms of weight that I'm putting in, and then I'm playing Pistol Whips. I'm going through the entire series at the moment because I've just had so many updates in Pistol Whip. All of like the base levels. You've got like 2 extra levels. You've got a campaign level. So I'm currently working through every single aspect of them, wearing these weights and playing them on the hard difficulty level. Yes, I'm playing with two pistols and no other modifiers. So they're basically hard with weights and trying to go through the entire series. Now on Monday, I went through like five levels on Monday and another 5 levels on Tuesday. I did a little bit of a quick video afterwards just to say hi, what was going on. So let's go back to Monday and Tuesday. Monday first, let's have a look at Monday. Hi, greetings and welcome. Sorry, bit exhausted at the moment. I know this is like in the middle of another video of the main weekly update at the moment, but I just wanted to record this. Sorry if my voice isn't carrying over, but I don't have the microphone here. I'm just working with the camera. But I've just finished filming the first 5 chapters of the first of Pistol Whip Leveled Up. Now, the reason that it's leveled up at the moment, and one of the reasons why I'm so exhausted, is A, we're playing playing it on hard mode, and B, I'm wearing these. These are 2 kilogram weights, 2 kilograms. And you see, and they fit on your arm. So 1, 2, And then two on the other arm. One. Two. And that goes in there. And that goes in there, right. And sorry, you're hearing that going off in the background. So there's two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8 kilograms of arm weights. And that's why I'm quite exhausted. And that's a current series that is going to be out soon. So back to the weekly update. Okay, and we're back. Okay, so that was a video that I made quickly after Monday. I also did another video after my little workout on Tuesday, and I can tell I am sweltering like a pig. I also think I might not remember, I might have gotten this wrong, but I think I said more in weight than was actually, I think it was 16. Did I say 16? Well, so as I say, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It was 8 kilograms worth of weight, not what I said in there, because I think I said the wrong one. But now, Tuesday's little video. And that's another 5 episodes. Sorry, doing this is really exhausting, but I hope you're enjoying the watch. I think I said it yesterday when I did the first 5 episodes. Each one of these is 2 kilograms. So that's 1, 2, 3, if I can get this off. 4 plus an extra kilogram of sweat that I build up as well. It's also a pain because I keep on punching these things whenever I'm trying, and I've also got a massive metal filing cabinet right there that I keep on punching. So if you ever see me like doing like the uppercut to people, I am purposely throwing wimpy uppercuts simply because every now and again I've gone and bash my hand right into the cabinet or the camera. Yeah, I don't really have much space around here to work in, but but yeah, that's another 5 episodes done. So now we're up to a total of 10 episodes. We've still got the next two levels that what are they called, DLCs to go through. In this particular run of 5, I did not only my favourite episode, but also favourite level, but also my worst level that I hate the most. Favourite one is I Bring You Death. I really love some of the moves and the actions they give you in that. The worst one was The Fall. But as you can see, as it's gone on, I am really quite exhausted when I'm getting up to these points. And more or less, instead of like dancing around shooting like I was with Black Magic, I'm more of a bang, bang, because I am sweltering. But yeah, back to the weekly update again. Okay, so yes, thank you very much Tuesday and Monday for that little brief discussion. So that's what I was doing on Monday and Tuesday. I'm still going to carry that on going on to next week until I've done the entire lot. And afterwards, after I finish that, I might start doing some work on maybe Beat Saber, because I think I did a fair amount of Beat Saber that I've leveled up as well. But I'm not sure about where in arm rests. Oh yeah, another reason that I kind of left that for a bit is after I did those, I absolutely felt totally, my arms were like aching. After Monday it was no problem, but after Tuesday it felt like every single muscle in my body was screaming at me. And then I was told, yeah, you need to warm up before you actually do these exercises. And I thought, that was it. warming up. I didn't use, because originally I used to do like a whole series of things, like do some Beat Saber first, maybe some lightsaber training before doing these with the weights, but I forgot to warm up. I don't think I'm going to do the warm up either, but yeah, I might do something a little bit like a Beat Saber before doing the next batch. Okay, Wednesday, we chilled out playing with our airplanes. Well, Ace Combat 7 is an old game. It comes out, it's mostly a flat screen game, but it's got a small VR experience in it. And a lot of people bought Ace Combat 7 for that VR experience. And it is an awesome VR experience. And the first time that you play it, the very first time that you play it, you rise up on top of this aircraft carrier, and like you see that, you hear the music playing in the background, you see like the people waving off, you feel the energy from the airplanes as they whir up their engines and launch off the platform right in front of you before it's your turn. And then before you know it, you get launched right into the sky, and you're like looking at this wonderful vista. And it's even amazing today, as I played from when I played it like a couple of years back when it first came out. Again, there was, I think, someone else that said that they did this, did the entire campaign, all three missions in record timing, and I beat that, brutally beat that previously. I mean, they play through the entire game entire campaign in easy mode. I played through the entire campaign in less time than he did. I can't remember what I said, like 40 minutes. And I did it on Ace Veteran level, which you can't get to Ace Veteran level unless you've completed the entire game in the first place. So you go through the entire missions. Each time you go through all the missions, you unlock new things, like you unlock new weapons, you unlock new airplanes to fly, you unlock new difficulties, you unlock new titles. So the idea is you keep on playing them over and over and over again, doing different missions, and then you can start using different airplanes to do those missions. And with different airplanes, you can use different missiles and different weapons and such. So one of my favourites was like the F-22 with the guided bomb. So I think even though I was playing on extra hard difficulty level, I got a little bit of, I wouldn't say a cheat, but it's because I'm playing with my preferred airplane, the 22, as well as using those guided homing bombs, which I think really made a good short work rather than the standard fire and forget missiles. Thursday, we was playing Solus Project on Thursday. Now, Solus Project, don't get me wrong, if you haven't played Solus Project, I certainly recommend it. It is sort of a health and it is a survival game where you crash on this alien world. And I do mean alien, because they're, although you think that it's uninhabited, as you go through the cave systems, you start to discover an alien civilization that was once there, and people were a primitive civilization that have been inscribed onto walls, stories and text about these people visiting from the sky, or the sky people as they call it. And as you know, as you're looking at it from a third party perspective, you're thinking, okay, this is an ancient civilization that was visited by aliens on a strange alien world. And it gets all types of weird, creepy and stuff that has happened. And the idea is that you kind of got to like survive through all of this, mostly by regulating your health, your temperature. Because if you go into water, you get wet. And if you're in cold areas, you're cold and wet, and therefore you start to get hypothermic, which can kill you. Hypothermia can kill you. Or if you don't eat enough food, you'll die of starvation. Or if you don't drink enough water, you'll die of dehydration. And if you don't get enough rest, you get fatigued. But So that's all the whole point of it being a survival game. When I first played this way back in 2017, I loved it. I was amazed. I was really awed by this game. However, coming back to it, playing it again today, or should I say last Thursday, I wasn't really feeling it. I wasn't feeling the energy that I was feeling last time. Okay, I don't do admit I turned the difficulty level a bit down because I didn't really want to be scavenging for food all this time whilst trying to explore the storyline. But considering I already knew the storyline, nothing new was wowing me. There was nothing else challenging to it because I knew what was coming, I knew what to do. I really wasn't feeling it the second time round, so it's probably not one of those games that you can play for a second time because you've already experienced it. The only thing that you've got to worry about is the survival element. Make sure you can find enough food to keep on eating. But if that's all that was in a game, then that's not worth playing a game because there's no real interest in just surviving. But yeah, I do recommend Solus Project for anyone who hasn't played it. Yeah, it is a good game, but just not for the second time round. So on Friday, I was going to continue playing Solus Project, but I really wasn't. Whoops. There goes my iPad, but I know what the rest of it is. On Friday, I was going to continue Solus Project, but unfortunately, because I really wasn't feeling the game, I wanted to try something different. Now, I did try to stream Star Citizen from my PC previously. Unfortunately, the way that the game is created, the way the game is played, is very tough on the hard drive. Such as, everything is done like the server based, and it is streamed down through to your computer and into your through your hard drive, and you're watching it through your hard drive through I mean, this is one of the reasons why Star Citizen doesn't require too much of doesn't require a great CPU chip, but does require an SSD and also a good graphics card, simply because majority of the stuff that you get is already has already been calculated and done for you at the server end, and it is just piped down through to your computer, streamed from your hard drive and up through your graphics card into your onto your display. Now, as the hard drive is one of the hardest working items, it is very hard for me to be using the same hard drive to be streaming or recording. So when I tried to stream it last time, it was so bad I had to delete it from my channel. It was so bad. It was like one frame every like 5 minutes. No lie, no joke. You just got like one frame and you had to wait ages just to see like the next thing going on. And it was at least like about 5 minutes past before you see any sort of update. I mean, on the computer, I saw it going a little bit faster, but on the stream output, it was just not watchable. It's just not feasible to use. So what I have done is I kind of sneakily borrowed my missus's PC and put the OBS software on there. Now, although my wife's laptop is a more recent purchase because she needed something for her work, it is about the same level of power as my laptop, which I bought several years ago. I think about 6 years ago or so. But yeah, I just installed OBS onto her system, and then I had my laptop playing outputted through to the capture card, and then the Elgato capture card plugged into her laptop, so then she can capture and stream the play of Star Citizen. And I think that actually worked quite well. The fact that I was using two different devices to actually play one game actually kind of worked, and I think we got a pretty decent frame rate with that. Mostly what I did during that little relaxing time of Star Citizen was just a little bit of bounty hunting. Went around, killed off a couple of HRTs, higher ranked targets, I think. HRTs, and yeah, just chilled out in the 890 jump, as you do, just because I wanted to see if this was all possible. So got into the Andromeda, took a couple of bounty hunting missions, completed them. Although I think they might have upped the ante a little bit on those, because normally bounty hunting missions I find kind of easy in the Andromeda. But that was getting a little bit tough. I think they're starting to make the bounty hunting missions a little bit tougher, which isn't too bad. I mean, I can still get through them. And then I just landed at one city. What city was it that I landed in? I think it was Area 18, where we then got out the 890 jump, put in our little plate, just registered ourselves in the medibed in the 890 jump, and walked to New Babbage and just chilled out. Just had a little look at the ship, see what's the big deal about the 890 jump. Yeah, I think although most people consider the 890 jump the Hangar Queen, it's the most expensive and biggest ship in the game at the moment. I think in the future, the 890 jump is going to be a really big, a really focal point ship, a really important ship, especially when it comes to the passenger gameplay. Because I think that passenger gameplay in Star Citizen is going to be a big thing. And we can't appreciate it yet because we don't have an idea of what the passenger systems are going to be. But I think that the passenger systems, where we're going to be bringing on passengers, we're going to have to be looking after the passengers. They'll have their own rooms, they'll have their own suites. We're going to need to feed them. We're going to need to entertain them whilst going from A to B. And yeah, we basically just have to make sure the guests on our ship are quite happy and healthy. And the 890 jump is going to be one of the biggest ships out there for the passenger cruise liners, right alongside with the Starliner from Crusader. I think it's Crusader. Yeah, the Starliner from Crusader. But hey ho, that has been this week for this week on the weekly update. I hope you've enjoyed watching this as much as I've been done in creating this. Guys, please don't forget to like and subscribe. We still want to try and see if we can get to that 1,000 milestone. But yeah, thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys out there.